안녕하십니까? 이재훈 치과 손영희입니다.
Hello, I'm Dr. Son Yong-hui from Ijeon Dental Office. Today, I'm going to talk about how to obtain primary or initial stability when it is hard to get the initial stability in placing an implant. So what do we need to do and how to resolve when primary or initial stability is hard to achieve? There are many reasons or causes behind the lack of initial stability, and we need to respond to each situation. Let's talk about it. For initial stability, in general, it is due to wider drill hole preparation compared to the nominal drill size. If we mistakenly use a bigger drill size, or during drilling, a drill may vibrate when it is outside the axis, and drill hole can get enlarged because of vibrations. Second, lack of lateral bony wall. If bone is lacking and basal bone is not sufficient to achieve the initial stability can get poor. And most frequently, we can lose the primary stability when bone quality is poor. So when initial stability is not good, it is not because of one specific reason. It is a complex problem combining various causes. TS implant is widely used. Based on TS implant, an OSSTEM's drilling concept has three drilling concepts. For soft bone, one size under drill needs to be used, and the contact surface between bone and implant should be maximized. For hard bone, bone and implant would come in contact only at the bottom, so that excessive initial stability can be reduced. So these are the three drilling concepts. For soft bone, one size undersized drill is used to achieve initial stability by placing an implant. How much initial stability needs to be achieved? In the conventional concept, when we say stable initial stability, that means it is about 20 or more Newton centimeters of initial stability. But based on my experience, the critical point of initial stability in connection with the success rate, as long as the initial stability is 16 Newton centimeter or higher, there's no problem in the survival of an implant. That's my personal view. So 16 Newton centimeter of initial stability would be the goal. 20 Newton centimeter of initial stability would be more stable, of course. If we cannot get the initial stability from the lateral wall, we rely on the basal bone. But if the basal bone is poor, that means if it is too soft or hard, when the quality is not good, it would be very hard to get an initial stability. We can think in simple terms. If we make a too wide drill hole, BIC would go down due to the reduced BIC. Initial stability can be reduced. For soft bone, even maximal contact between an implant and bone has been achieved. initial stability can be poor for soft bone. So in terms of the result, we cannot achieve an initial stability when PIC is reduced. Second, PIC is appropriate, but bone is soft. Those two would be the primary reasons why initial stability is poor. Then, how can we overcome the poor initial stability? Let's talk about it. Clinically, there are two reasons why initial stability is lost. First, as we know, insertion torque cannot be achieved when the bone is soft. From the beginning to the end of placement, initial stability is poor because bone is very soft. So these two are very unfavorable conditions. When we place an implant and we want to place it deeper, the implant hits the bottom and it spins and comes back up. In this case, it is because the lateral wall bone quality is too soft. When initial stability is not achieved until the end of placement, as the bone is soft. But the second situation I described is even worse than that. When we apply the torque a little bit more on the implant to place it a little bit deeper, the lateral wall should be able to hold the implant as it goes into the basal bone, but it fails and the implant spins and it's coming back up. Then the implant becomes unusable. In this case, when initial stability cannot be achieved, most simple way to address it is to use a wider and longer implant. Here, a caveat. When you use a long implant, additional drilling is necessary at the bottom in order to avoid the second scenario. The basal bone cannot be penetrated into, and implant spins and comes back up. We need to do additional drilling when we place a long implant. If we cannot obtain the initial stability with a certain diameter of implant, we can attempt to use one size bigger diameter implant to get the initial stability. By doing so, if initial stability goes up, you can use the implant as it is. So when we use a wider implant, initial stability can be increased. That is the most commonly used way to address poor initial stability. But buccal lingual width or implant mesiodistal distance is lacking, the use can be restricted. In this patient, number 26 is missing. On the panorama, the cortical bone is considerably lacking and the bone quality looks soft. Also, on CT, cortical bone is hardly there. There's no way to achieve initial stability from the cortical bone. It can only be obtained from the cancellous bone. The flap is raised and the bone quality is identified. So it's not good quality bone. A drilling hole is formed, followed by implant placement. So it looks very simple procedure. The implant diameter first was 4.5 millimeters and it was replaced by 5 millimeters. 4.5 millimeter diameter could not achieve initial stability, so 5 millimeter diameter implant was used and the case was completed. up to prosthesis. The second way, when initial stability is not good enough, we can use the submerging. And we need to have sufficient healing period. For mandible, loading can be done at week 8, but in this case, we need to wait way longer than that before an implant is uncovered and loaded. In this patient, number 36 and 37 are missing. At number 37, the defect after extraction is not healed and remains. Second, initial stability needs to be obtained from the basal bone, but as you can see, it is very close to the mandibular canal, so it is not possible to get initial stability from the basal bone, and the flap is raised. An implant is placed at number 6 position. At number 37, diameter 6 millimeter implant is placed. I really cannot say I placed an implant there. I should say I just put an implant in there. Initial stability value was meaningless. It was below 5 newton centimeter. It was barely enough to connect the cover screw. No graft was done, and the membrane covered the site before finishing the surgery. Post-op panorama in number 37 CT. You can see the situation was like this, and the implant is like floating in there. Will bone attach the implant, and will implant integrate with bone over time? You can see the progress of ossification. Second surgery was done, and prosthesis was delivered before finishing the case. So as you can see here, number 37 implant, if you look at the distal aspect, there is a lack of ossification. There is a difference in terms of blackening. Over time, the difference in the blackening disappears and bone is regenerated. Pre-op, post-op implant placement after the delivery of prosthesis. If you look at the CT, bone is regenerated. The best way to confirm bone regeneration is to find the lining of the cortical bone. That is the sign of regeneration, especially at the lingual side. Bone is stably regenerated. The third way, when we expect initial stability will be poor, we can take this action in advance. So osseodensification can be used to increase the initial stability. In this patient, at number 10, there's a fracture in the posterior bridge, so implant placement is planned. If you look at the CT, the pontic area, the bone quality there is very poor. So here, an implant will be placed. Osseodensification method can be used for the implant placement according to the plan. The bridge is cut. Number 17 is extracted. When we place an implant, I believe you have already seen it or you are already using it. Many people already use it. The denser burr for osseodensification. You need to use it in the reverse direction. If you turn it in the clockwise direction, the cutting is too much, so you need to use in the counterclockwise direction for osseodensification. The osseodensification burr can be used for all types of implants. The drilling protocol can be found in the company's homepage. Drilling is done, an implant is placed and submerged. If you look at poster panorama and CT, it is placed like this. Initial stability. Despite osseodensification method is used, it's not very good, so it is submerged. As a result, prosthesis was completed and not much problem. In the follow-up, post-op follow-up, excessive remodeling or crystal bone loss did not occur, so it is maintained. Osseodensification method is useful in increasing initial stability, I agree with that, but if we use one size undersized drilling, I don't think there is a difference between that approach and osseodensification. I don't believe there is any difference between those two. So osseodensification method needs more data accumulation. Until then, to increase the initial stability, I believe one step undersized drilling would be as effective as osseodensification method. Not a significant difference between those two. I have talked about briefly how to deal with poor initial stability or when we expect poor initial stability. I have a lot to talk about, but there's a training course to talk about in depth about this topic. If you want more details, if you want to increase the initial stability even just a little bit more before surgery, we need to accurately determine the bone quality where an implant is to be placed. At the time of drilling, accurate drilling without changing the axis is very important. If necessary, additional tool or device such as osseodensification method can be used to improve the bone quality at the site. When favorable initial stability cannot be achieved despite using such methods, an implant should be submerged and you need to wait longer for the healing and you do the secondary surgery. After that, implant prosthesis can be delivered, so it is desirable to rely on passage of time. In this session, we talked about how to address initial stability problem for placing an implant. Initial stability is very important for implant placement. So please remember what I have said and hopefully apply it clinically. Thank you very much for your attention.